TT, welcome back to the channel. It's a girl, Veramore, and I'm back with another reaction video. Guys, I'm super excited. Today, I'm going to react to somebody new, and this is Destiny Clips. And we have Destiny Debates, Candace Owens, and it gets personal fast, okay? It gets personal. Super excited to get into this one. Guys, this sounds like something that's gonna be really, really interesting. If you haven't seen any of my reaction to Candace Owens, hit the link above. I have a couple of videos which I reacted to from Candace, so please kindly check it out. Super excited to get into this one. But before we get started, we have some amazing people watching us for the first time. If you are new here, hello, I'm Vera. I do reaction videos. We have two different artists on here. We have two different songs from all over the world. This is something that I love. Why not join Vera City? Hit the subscribe button below, turn on the post notification bell so that you can always be the first person to know whenever a new video drops. And that, guys, let's go.
I mean, I'm not telling people, like I said, I tell people how I actually live and what I actually believe. And
you,
I don't know, and
to,
I don't know that you do that.
I don't
justify acting like
this looks different.
Well, I don't justify trying to prescribe lifestyles to people.
What?
Don't justify trying to prescribe lifestyles to people.
It's not prescribing a lifestyle.
Of course
it's just,
it is.
When somebody said
that they would be happy not having kids, you were like, oh, she sounds like a conceited
That's
something.
Not what
like,
she said.
That was a
That's
bit,
not
yeah,
what
that
she
was the
said.
TikTok clip you were responding to.
That was
to.
Not what she said, and I can tell you exactly what she
that
said.
That she was caught to go on
I said there was absolutely no reason to make a comment that suggests that people, she was actually being insulting to people that had kids. It wasn't just one video. She makes multiple videos about how great life is if you don't have kids. If I was making videos with my kids saying about how great life is if you just, you know, stop being a loser and get married, you people would come after you because people hate the traditional lifestyle.
Stop being a loser.
Wait, but that's
get
what
married.
You guys say. Get married, have kids. That's the only way to go. Otherwise, you're a loser.
No, we do not. That is, you're just making up words
oh,
that
okay,
have
so
never
maybe
come
that's
out
not
of
the
my
case.
Mouth.
So wait, so if somebody said, if there was a young woman and she's like, I'm 20, I think I want to go to a career and be a whatever. I don't think I want to have a family. I don't think life's for me. You would say, okay, well, that's fine. You should make that
no,
choice.
No, I would say that's completely normal at 20 years old. That's most.
Oh, wait.
Most
so then they should change their opinion later on. What if she was 25 or 30? She's like, no, I don't think I want to have kids. Would you be okay?
If
that's
she,
fine.
If she was a 20-year-old person and she was saying that I don't think that I want to have kids, then what I would say is that's pretty typical because you're 20 years old and you haven't yet had the biology thing happen to you. Which, like, when they say that your biological clock starts ticking, it's very real. When you get into your mid-20s, you have a totally different feeling.
So if
like
a woman is 25 or 30 and says, I don't have kids, I think I like my career, I'm gonna stick with it, you'd say, okay, that's fine. It's your choice.
Yeah, as long as that person isn't trying to, and by the way, I think that that person would probably be, it would be unusual. Like, it wouldn't be, the majority of women, I think, do want to have families and want to aspire to family, and that's fine. But when you try to create a brand of it, and you say things like, oh, well, you know, if you have kids, then you can't just smoke pot and stay in bed and be naked all day. This is actually something that, like, Seth Rogen just said.
Okay.
What you're doing sounds there is awesome. You're actually trying to, you're 30, how old
Five.
Are you? You're 35 years old.
Yep.
Wow.
Okay, so what are you, what is that? What are you...
What do I do?
Like, if you were 20
well,
and you
say,
were saying this stuff.
I'm a millionaire. I travel the world. I get to research and talk about whatever I want. I get to talk to cool people like you and other people. I live in Miami in a high rise for $5,000 a month. I mean, I think my life is pretty okay. I mean, okay.
But I'm saying, like, what are you doing when you're trying to sell to people that, you know, being a hoe is cool, smoking pot, saying it.
I don't
like,
necessarily think that being a hoe is cool.
Are you going to age
out?
You
know,
you're a 35-year-old man, right?
I am a 35-year-old man,
you're kind of doing the, like, I'm a college dorm kid and I'm trying to make everything sound cool. But I just want to point out the fact that you're a 35-year-old man and your words should matter and they should have weight. Like,
I agree.
If you were 20, I'd be like, I get it. When you're 35... Mm-hmm. You know, say things with conviction. Say things that have meaning.
Say plenty of things with conviction, yes.
You know, and
like when I asked you, what would you recommend to a woman at 25 and 30? I didn't just start rambling about what a 20-year-old should do and how biologically blah, 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 blah. I would say exactly what I would tell a woman at 25 or 30.
Yeah, I know, but your behavior, and I will appreciate that people that are younger won't understand what I'm saying until you hit 35, which is, I'm going to be 35 this year.
Wow.
Okay.
You're acting like you're a college dorm kid.
Yeah, and your catty insults towards people online make you seem like a high school mean girl.
Okay.
I mean, like, what do you mean? Like, we all have our things.
But you're
like,
selling to them things that you know aren't good. So
what do you think
I'm
selling
to
them?
If you're
a
25-year-old, like, when I'm on the Whatever podcast and I'm surrounded by women that are in their 20s and they're saying, like, you know, the whole life is good, the reason why I said to that girl that I'm going to pray for you is because I know that she's going to have a different perspective when she's older. So I'm not upset by that. I don't feel like that needs to be attacked when those young girls are around.
Oh yeah, do whatever podcast.
When I'm speaking to 35-year-old man, okay,
And what do you think I'm selling?
I was trying to put it without saying she wants to get for the girl.
Well, do you think I'm telling people to be a hoe?
What I said when you were defending the lifestyle of being a hoe, why are you doing that?
I don't think I defend the lifestyle of being
you
a hoe.
You did a whole video basically saying that none of my points of me trying to tell these women that they essentially you can do something better, you don't have to sell your body, this was your like snazzy video comeback to it. Why are you making a comeback? Yes, you can make a video and be like, why can't someone do hair? But why would you as a 35-year-old man want to sell something to someone or make it seem okay or cool or relevant when you know it's harmful to them? I don't get that because of your age.
So, yeah, so I don't understand. I don't know what you took away from the video was, if there are researchers that give you like talking points to my videos. But generally what I talk about is when it comes to lifestyle, you have to analyze both sides.
Exactly.
If you grow up incredibly religiously conservative and you are like shamed out of sex and you don't have sex with anybody in your whole life because you're super, you know, hyper cognizant of your virginity and all of these like weird things, and that's like coming from an unhealthy external place, to say, oh, well, maybe that's worth exploring. On the flip side, if you grow up like hyper liberal and you've 20 guys by the time you're, you know, 20 years old and you just want to bang everybody and you've got like weird associations with men and everything, I'd say, hey, you should probably slow down. It's probably not healthy. I just encourage people to like explore, honestly, to have like conversations with themselves, with their parents, could be with priests, could be with therapists, could be whatever, and to kind of figure out like what works for them and don't get pushed into one direction from a culture side. It could be the left encouraging people to be way too promiscuous, or it could be the right for people that are shaming people for being promiscuous and saying that, well, one lifestyle of family stuff is going to biologically be suited towards you as you get older. I think both of these are equally stupid because it just pushes people in the other direction.
So you don't believe in anything? What you're saying
is that what you got from that?
Well, you're not committing to
I
anything.
Believe in actually thinking for yourself.
That's well, what that I got from all of that
exists in this like paradigm. Crazy. Where if you're 100 people by the time you're 20, probably not healthy. If you've never had sex before and you're 30, probably not healthy.
Candace,
and that you should probably
you
like so
you
gravitate
should teaching a lifestyle
like,
of people. She wants to happy, everyone to lead their life like
and you kind of like explore in there and don't be shamed out of exploring from one side to the other. Don't be pushed into something because somebody like Candace Owens or somebody like Stephen Bunnell tells you that you have to do a particular thing, but just like kind of explore.
I don't tell people that they have to do a particular thing, but if I see somebody that's doing heroin, I'm not going to be like, you know, it is whatever, and it's just like whatever.
Do you think that heroin is comparable to recreational sex?
I am. Quite frankly, I actually think a woman, as the one that I sat across from when you were critiquing this video, who says that she slept with up to, 20 men per night? Yeah, it's just as bad. And I know that that has to be hurting her soul. So I look at her as a human being.
Hurting her
and,
soul?
Yeah.
What if she just has a different lifestyle
she
than you?
She does.
That's true.
No,
what do you mean? You know, she's telling you, she was very honest, actually. And that's why I appreciate her, because she was very honest that for her, it
she
is
actually talked down on
okay?
those
But
ladies.
When I see that individual,
she talked down
a young
on
woman
them.
Saying that she'll sleep and see up
Which
to 10
really
to 20
cool.
clients per night, that's a broken
She was
individual.
Already judging
and
them.
It's,
and
when
broken
you, just as when you see
why?
Somebody who says that, you know, they're doing heroin or doing this, they don't need the guy, the cool guy at the party to be like, yeah, man, it's whatever. Like, it's like, no, you actually, like, structure, you need somebody to say to you, you don't have to do this. There's so much better potential within you. You are young. You have your entire life ahead of you. Let's figure out what it is that you're great at. I understand the economic concerns. It's a really tough economy and it's easy money, but there's other things that you can do to make money that will give you better self-value. And so that's why I say that I think that what you're doing as a 35-year-old man is you're
I mean, as you said, 35-year-old man.
When you make videos and you're replying to conservatives who are rightfully saying that this lifestyle is not good, which should be abundantly clear to every single person, yeah, what you're trying to do is lie in a clever way. You're and ultimately, like I said, if you were 20, I'd be fine with it. But when
first
you're,
of all, I don't know why if I was 20, why that would
because
make you
exactly
fired. Because
you'd have the same influence in your audience regardless.
Because your
number
brain's
one.
Not developed when you're 20.
Number two, so what? Your brain's always developing as you grow.
No, your brain develops when you're 25, 26 years
are
old,
you
and so
serious?
When you're a 20-year-old and they have a bunch
that
of positions and don't hold them. To it.
I think
that's
with
you
brain
time,
development.
Gonna,
I think that's with life experience. I think as you grow
no,
older,
but like
you
literally factually, I know if you want to Google this, but your brain develops when you're 25, 26.
Wow.
If you Google it factually, the 25 number came from one study that was done like 30 years ago where they only measured brain development up to 25. And the reality is the plasticity of your brain and every other structure of your brain continues to grow into your 30s. That's technically where that number comes from. It's not true. You can look it up later if you want. The 25, 26 thing is a misnomer. It's not
okay.
actually true.
Well, like okay, I said, if you were fine. If you were 20,
sure.
I would accept, but there's such a thing as objective truth and
people
are sure.
20 or 35, none of our
objective truth related.
Whatever
how
they
you
want.
Should live your life?
It's yeah, no, about things that are harmful to people. Like, objectively speaking.
So I'm curious,
like,
wait, what is the upper bound on recreational sex that you think is harmful or not harmful?
Well, when you're selling your body and sleeping with old...
I'm not asking that. I'm just saying, what is the upper bounds on recreational sex that you think is, like healthy for a human being?
Well,
like, if you go past this, you're, like, clearly over the line.
I'm not going to say to a person, this is a number that you should sleep with, and this
okay,
makes
well,
you bad.
Well, don't accuse me of believing in nothing and not speaking out of position.
I'm
well, you only attack the most extreme people.
Specifically talking about the whatever
yeah,
podcast.
I'm going to attack the same people that you do. If some woman is on saying, like, oh, you can 20 guys a night and do OnlyFans with 18. I'm gonna say, in general, that's a pretty wacky, that's a pretty out there position. I argue with tons of people over this. I don't encourage people to start
OnlyFans. But what are you trying to do? What purpose are you trying to fulfill? When you, as a 35-year-old man, see me sitting down with these young women.
35.
You don't need to do this for money, and you like attack it and try to be like, Candace is just a bitch, or like whatever, like she's blah, 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 blah. She's just being a high school mean girl. It's like, no, I am trying to tell these women that they are worth more. And when I said to that girl, at the end of it, which I don't believe you showed, that I will pray for you and that you can do much more than this, that came from the heart, actually.
No,
they
you don't need to pray for
her. I can say to a non-religious, I will pray for
you. Don't need
okay,
to pray
you
for
with your, you know, I know that you went to a Jesuit school and you got some issues with somebody.
Why do you think I have issues?
But I meant that because...
I loved my high school.
Because for me to say, like, I meant what I said to her, that I would pray for her. Like, her, when she was describing
why
life,
she
was very
upfront. Her that you'll pray for her?
Why do you want to pray for her?
I did pray for her.
Then do it privately. Why
exactly.
You you're only telling her that because you think you've got such a condescension about you. You've got such an air of superiority.
Exactly.
Superiority? Because yeah, I said I would... God forbid someone says they'll pray. That's obviously an air of superiority because they're saying they're going to include you in their prayers.
Well, I mean, like, when you say, God forbid, but, like, quite literally, God forbid. Isn't there a whole story of a lady going to a temple and quietly putting, like, 2% or whatever
What is anti-Christian about this? If you say I'll pray for you, it's obviously you trying to be better. It's like, no, why are you even reacting to that? I'll pray for you. I'll pray for everybody that listens and watches this show. When people say that they're going to pray for you, they actually mean it, you guys.
No, the way you
no
actually say
double entendre. Unless you said it wasn't. Anybody that can go back and watch that clip, you will see that I was not speaking above her. I actually genuinely responded to that
because
she was
clip,
so
yeah?
honest and she was so forthcoming. She was. I thought I actually wanted to do more stuff with her, and we tried to reach out with her because she wasn't trying to lie or trying to pretend like her, you know, her lifestyle was for health. She was clear that it was for money, and she was like, I'm not going to lie. This is why I do this. And I genuinely prayed for her. Actually, we were not enemies that were sitting across the table. So, no, it was not condescending when I said I pray for you. It was a fact. When I left, I said, I will keep you in my prayers because I have in my heart, I want to see that girl in 10 years and know that she left that field and she is able to speak to women that are still within it and think that they have to sell their bodies for money and sleep with 10 men per night. I am going to continue to pray for that young woman because we need people who transform their lives to then show people that they can transform their lives. And it's not condescending to pray for anybody ever. So
okay, I will pray for you too then. Okay.
You should.
Okay.
I hope you pray for me. I want you to include me in your prayers. I want every person watching this to include. But I feel like our society's gotten so like anti-Christian. Like, oh my God, they're trying to get something. It's like, no, like I'll pray for you. I will literally pray for every single person that I think needs a prayer, and I felt like she needed a prayer. Like she could be there, you know.
Okay.
What makes you think she needs prayer? You know, I actually listened to that. I watched the video, the whatever podcast, and I also reacted to it. So if you haven't seen my reaction, please check it out on my playlist on Candace. When I saw that video, I didn't even agree with her. Everything she said. First of all, she was judging those girls like, why would you even judge them? You yourself talking, are you perfect? You're not perfect. Then why would you say you would pray for her? Why would you pray? Are you a pastor? I don't allow just anyone pray for me. I said the same thing in that video. I was like, I don't allow just anyone pray because I don't know the kind of spirit that is in you. I don't know if it's the Holy Spirit or if it's a demon. So you don't allow just anyone pray for you. Anyone just lay hands on you. No, 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 no. I don't do that. I don't allow just anyone pray for me. Okay? So you can't just hold my hand or place your hand on my... Nah, I'm not going to allow you to do that. So you saying I'll pray for you is like you are holier than her. You're trying to tell her that. The way she said it was like she was holier than her. Even when she was talking about the video in her own podcast, she was reacting to what she said. And she was like, she even told her, why was she wearing the rosary? She was judging these ladies. And it's not meant to be that way. She was already judging them in her heart. She was already judging the other lady. Why are you wearing the rosary when you don't believe in the rosary? All that is blah, 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 blah. I also went on to say that I used to wear the rosary in my secondary school. We wear the rosary a lot because jewelries were not allowed in school. Jewelries were not allowed. The only form of jewelry you could wear was the rosary. And so we wore it as a form of big girl, you know, big, big, big high school girls. So that was what we did in secondary school. We wore the rosary, even though we didn't know how to pray it. I was born in a Catholic church. That's where I got the name Veronica, which is my baptismal name, which I shortened to Vera. So Veronica is my baptismal name. I was born in a Catholic church, but I didn't grow up in the Catholic Church. We changed church as we grew up. So I don't know. I don't even know how to pray the rosary, but I have the rosary. I wear it around my neck. So please. All this holier than thou, righteous, over righteous attitudes, to me is just bullshit. I think destiny, I agree 100% with destiny. The fact that you're a virgin, you don't do shit, does not mean that your life will turn out fine, better than those girls that do hookup and stuff. I'm not promoting hookup. I'm not saying you should go into hookup. I, for one, I don't do hookup, and I am definitely, I'm not the hookup type. But I don't judge people that do it. I don't judge them because it is their life. That's probably the kind of environment they grew up in, the kind of circumstances, the kind of situation they found themselves in, okay? So that is their life. So it is not now, it is not meant for you to now start judging them openly and say, oh, you guys are this, you guys are, oh, come on. Come on. And the fact that Chandes kept saying, you're a 35-year-old man, you're a 35-year-old man, I can't count how many times she repeated that 35-year-old man. Age has got nothing to do with this. She said if it was 20, she would have understood. That is complete bullshit to me. If it like be 20, if it like be 15, if it like be 10, come on. Age isn't even maturity. She's going to be 35 this year. Age is not maturity. That's just the thing. What do you guys think about this video? Let me hear your comments. I would love to hear from you guys. Okay, I really enjoyed this one. If you enjoyed this video as much as I did, give it a huge thumbs up. And please share this video. And if you're new here, join Viracity. Hit the subscribe button below. Turn on the post notification bell so that you can always be the first person to know whenever a new video drops. And that's guys. See you in the next one. Love you. Bye, ya.